Was it not thou who dried up the sea, the waters of the great deep, who made the depths of the sea a pathway for the redeemed to cross over? So the ransomed of the Lord will return and come with joyful shouting to Zion, and everlasting joy will be on their heads. They will attain gladness and joy, and sorrow and sighing will flee.
Thank you. Why did God take them to Sinai instead of to Zion? Because of unbelief. God decided to test them a little, just a little bit. And he let them come to an area where there was no drinkable water. And what did they do? They murmured against God. And so God said, these folks are not ready for Mount Zion. So he took them where? To Mount Sinai, the Mount of Bondage, where the present Jerusalem is still focused. Did we get it? Where does God want to take us today? Where did God want to take us shortly after 1844?
Heaven.
The heavenly Zion. In 1 month and 20 days, it will be the 173rd birthday of 1844. Does God want for us to still be here?
No.
Isn't it amazing how we know the answers to these questions? I mean, we have the intellectual answer to these questions. The question is, folks, when are we going to allow God, Jesus, to be formed in us? That's the question. Because once you answer that question, then you're focused on what? Zion up there. Where Jesus is at, in the second apartment. So when you pray to God, you email your address, you email your prayer to not Jesus, not Savior, but mediatorial high priest. Because if you send it to the Savior, it's going to take a little longer to get there. See, he's completed his job as Savior. His job now is mediatorial high priest. And the address is not apartment one, heaven, but apartment two. And the zip code, are you ready for the zip code? If you miss the zip code, you're in trouble. The zip code is faith of Jesus. Amen. Any questions on this? I gotta stop. Is the bell or the siren or the horn? There we go. Any questions on this? What we've covered? What? Why did God take him to Mount Sinai instead of Zion?
Unbelief.
They resisted God's promises. Are you and I guilty of the same thing today? It's our choice when we're to change this around. Any questions on what we've covered today?
Mm-hmm. Just a quick text that confirms what you're saying. In Hebrews 3, it says, they, in verse 10, they do always err in their heart, they have not known my way, so I swear in my wrath, they shall not enter my rest. Verse 12, take heed, brethren, lest there be in any of you an evil heart of unbelief and departed from the living God. That's talking about the wilderness experience. And in verse 1, let us therefore, in verse in chapter 4, fear, lest the promise be left us of entering into this rest, any of you should see to come short.
God is still looking for a people today. He wanted to write his laws in the hearts of the people in Mount Sinai, and then he'd be able to take them to Zion. God is still looking for a generation of people today upon whose hearts he may write his law.
Amen.
When you do that,
amen,
you have decided to let Jesus be formed in you.
Amen.
And it is my prayer that that will be the goal of your life.
Amen.
Let's pray. Loving Father, we thank you for answering our request to meet with us through your Holy Spirit and to recognize the application of Mount Sinai, Hagar, and the Old Covenant and how we are still being influenced by those three symbols. Help us to recognize that Jesus is a complete in quantity and perfect in quality redeemer, and that when we surrender ourselves to him, he guarantees to form his character in us. I pray that that will be the experience for each one of us, because we ask this request in Jesus' name.
Good morning. Can I make a quick announcement?
Yes.
I got a close friend that this is his first time here at church, and he knows nothing about the